So after I post this video on Threads, a lot of people say the answer here is 30, but a lot of people say the answer is actually 18. So who is correct? Let's have a look. The question is that we have these two people, and when this person is 4 years old, this person is 10. Now this person is 12, we would like to know how old this person is. So it looks like we can just go from 4 to 12 by multiplying by 3, right? So let's do the same thing. 10 times 3, and we should just end up with 30 for the answer. No, it's actually not correct. Here's the deal. When you cannot just multiply the same number throughout the process, this right here, we say the quantities, they are not directly proportional. We cannot just multiply to get the answer. And the reason why is because you have to think about how many years do you have to wait going from 4 years old to 12 years old? 8 years, right? So you will have to look at this as starting from 4 years old, after 8 years, we end up with 12. Same thing here, 10 years old, and then we will have to wait 8 years, and we will end up with 18. So 18 is the correct answer for this. So you can see that we're adding the same number throughout the process, and that means the quantities are differ by a constant, right? And you can look at this question this way too. 4 year old versus 10 years old, differ by 6, yeah? And just imagine they are brothers or sisters. After 8 years, they will still have to differ by 6 years. So if you have 12, you add 6 to it, you get 18, and you're done. So again, in this situation, the ages are not directly proportional. So now I would like to give you guys an actual example where the quantities are actually directly proportional. And this right here, it's going to be very useful when you have to solve some situation questions. So here's the deal. Suppose you have a job and that pays you hourly. It's the same wage per hour. And let's say you work for 3 hours, and you get paid a total of $60. Now my question for you guys is that, if you work for 12 hours, then how much are you going to get paid? You have a few ways to do it. You can say, okay, going from 3 to 60, that's just multiply by 20. And the 20 means what? 20 is actually how much money you get paid per hour, right? Yeah, 3 hours, $60. So each hour is $20. And then under the same situation, we can just multiply 12 hours by $20, and you end up with a total of $240. So as you can see, hours versus how much you make, they are directly proportional. And in fact, you can also look at it this way. Going from 3 hours to 12 hours, that's just 4 times as much, right? If you multiply this by 4, you get 12. And in fact, we can do the same thing. 60 multiplied by 4, you also get 240.